As we begin this Logos training, I want us to survey the land so that you can see the big picture. And in order to set this up, I want you to imagine that you're sitting behind the steering wheel of the vehicle that you drive. And you'll notice right in front of you, you have an instrument panel. And there are a lot of lights and gauges and bells and whistles on that panel. Everything is designed to help you drive that vehicle safely and effectively. Well, obviously, we're not driving a vehicle right now, but we are using Logos Bible software. And right in front of you, you'll see an instrument panel in Logos. So let's survey this land by going through this instrument panel that you're going to constantly be referring to, because everything on this panel is designed to help you study the Bible and research your resources very effectively. Now, when I'm referring to the instrument panel in Logos, I'm referring to the row of icons and menus going across the top of your screen. Let's start with the toolbar in the upper left-hand corner. You'll notice that Logos supplies three icons for us: the home, the library, and search. The home icon will open and close the home page. So anytime you want the home page to appear, you simply click the home icon. All I want you to see right now is that the home page is a pane that's going to lay on top of anything that you have open. It's not going to close anything, but it will lay on top of anything that's open on the desktop. So you can click the home icon again and close the home page. To its right, you'll see the book icon, which is the library. Think of the library as an electronic bookshelf that houses all of your resources. Anytime you want to open a book, you can go to the library and do so. Again, I want you to notice that the library is a pane that lays on top, again, of anything that you have open. So you click the library icon, and that will open or close the library. Now I want you to click the search icon, which will open the search panel. You can search for words, phrases, Bible references. What I want you to see right now is the search icon will open the search panel, but it's not going to close it. You have to manually close the search panel. So go ahead and close the search panel. And to the right of the three icons, you'll see menus. First of all, focus on the documents menu. This is where you go to create all sorts of documents inside of Logos. For example, in Word, we create Word documents. In Excel, we create spreadsheets. In PowerPoint, we create slideshows. Well, here in Logos, you can create note files, reading plans, prayer lists, and this is where you do it, at the Documents menu. You come here to create those documents, and then you return here to reopen them, edit them, delete them, whatever you would like. For now, just know that you can create all sorts of documents or files inside of Logos. And then you'll notice the Guides menu. The Guides menu houses the heart and core of Logos Bible software, which are these five guides. You'll notice the Passage Guide, Exegetical Guide, Bible Word Study, Sermon Starter Guide, and the Topic Guide. I affectionately refer to these guides as our personal research assistant. And then you'll see the Tools menu. The Tools menu houses a variety of tools inside of Logos. Think of the Tools menu as a carpenter's tool belt that holds various tools that he may need as he frames a house, a hammer, a saw, or whatever. Here on the Tools menu, miscellaneous tools to assist you as you study the Bible and research your resources. And then in the upper right-hand corner, you'll notice the Layouts menu. The Layouts menu is where you go to save the current arrangement of your Logos desktop. Imagine that you've got Bibles, commentaries, dictionaries open on the screen, and you like how they're arranged. Well, you can take a picture of the Logos desktop, give it a name, and then return to the Layouts menu and open that layout anytime you want. Think of the Layouts menu as where you go to basically bookmark the entire Logos desktop. And then notice right in the middle of the instrument panel, you're going to see a command box. The command box is where you go to type in your own instructions or commands for Logos. For example, let's say you get tired of going to the library to open the ESV. Well, you can type ESV in the command box, press the Enter key, and that Bible will open for you. You'll learn all sorts of shortcuts that you can type in the command box. And then to the right of the command box, you're going to see a shortcuts area, the shortcuts bar. This is where you're going to place your own icons. Logos, by default, gives us three icons that we just observed. But you can place as many icons as you want on the shortcuts bar so that you can access your favorite features just with a click of a button. I also want you to notice in the extreme upper right-hand corner of the Logos screen a question mark icon. This is actually the help menu. You can access a variety of things here, but specifically you want to go to this question mark icon, the help menu, to access the Logos help files. Also notice in the upper right-hand portion of this instrument panel a double arrow icon, and this is extremely important. This icon is called synchronization, and here's how it works. As long as you are working online, every so often, Logos will back up all of your work. So if you've created a note file or a reading plan, Logos will automatically back up those documents to the Logos servers at their headquarters. And then when you start Logos on another computer or next week on this computer, Logos will synchronize all of your computers with your work. For example, let's say you travel with a laptop, but you have a desktop back at home or in your office. Whatever you do on the road, on the laptop, when you get back home and open your desktop, all of your documents, all of your work will be synchronized inside of Logos. This is great news. And this synchronization also works across platforms. Now think about this. Let's say you have a Mac laptop, but you have a PC desktop. Whatever you do on the Mac laptop will show up on the PC desktop and vice versa. So Logos is automatically backing up and synchronizing your work. Now keep in mind, you can work with Logos offline as much as you want. All of your work is stored locally on the computer that you're working on. But when you're online, all of your work will be synchronized and backed up to the Logos servers. So great news. So there's a brief introduction to your instrument panel. We're going to constantly be coming back to this instrument panel as we study the scripture and research our resources.